friends, welcome to Science Online class. So today we are going to discuss about the topic our human body and its different parts and their functions. So students, come to our point. Let's start from discuss about the brief description of this skeletal system. Our skeletal system. Our bones join together to form a skeleton. This system makes up the skeletal system. The bones support our body, protects our organs, and allows us to move. A good example of how bones protect our organs includes the way our ribcage surrounds organs such as the heart and lungs. Let's go to muscular system. Muscular system consists of soft parts in our body called muscles. They are attached to the bones. Muscles allow a person to move, speak, and chew. They control heartbeat, breathing, and digestion. Muscles help us while walking, running, swimming, writing, or speaking. The muscular system contains more than 600 muscles that work together to enable the full functioning of the body. Respiratory system. The human respiratory system is a series of organs responsible for breathing. It consists of the nose, throat, windpipe, and lungs. The nose helps us to breathe in and breathe out. The oxygen enters from our nose and passes through the windpipe to reach the lungs. In the lungs, the oxygen enters our blood and then it is circulated. The windpipe connects our nose and lungs. It allows the passage of air through it. And finally, lungs are organs which help us breathe in and breathe out air. After oxygen enters the lungs through windpipe, it is carried out to all the parts of the body. Come to number 4, circulatory system. The circulatory system comprises of the heart, the blood, and the blood vessels. It is an organ system that permits blood to circulate and transport nutrients. In other words, it is the transport system of the body. The heart is the pump which circulates and sends blood throughout the body, carrying oxygen to every cell. After delivering oxygen, the blood returns to the heart. The heart then sends the blood to the lungs to pick up more oxygen. This cycle repeats over and over again. Blood vessels are tiny tubes that carry blood away from and towards the heart. So, the circulatory system can be called a process of circulating blood carrying oxygen from the heart to different parts of the body through blood vessels. 5. Digestive system. Digestion is the process of changing food into a simpler form so that it can be used by the body. The digestive system consists of the part of the body that work together to turn food and liquid into simpler substances. Mouth, food pipe, stomach, small intestine, large intestine and anus are the various organs of digestive system. While chewing food, teeth broke off. Break off the food into simpler substances and the saliva in our mouth makes it soft. After we swallow our food, it travels through the windpipe into our stomach. In the stomach, the food mixes with digestive juices. After around 4 hours, the food turns into a soft paste and goes to the small intestine. The digested food enters blood through the walls of small intestine. Then it is carried by the blood to different. Number 6. Excretory system. As we know, our body produces waste products. So it is necessary to remove the waste from the body regularly. Excretion is the process of removal of all waste from our body. So it is the job of excretory system. Materials from our body. The excretory system consists of kidney, lungs and skin. The human body consists of a pair of kidneys which clean or purifies our blood and removes waste materials. The urine is then passed out of the body. The lungs removes waste products, that is carbon dioxide, from our body. The skin also removes waste water from our body in the form of sweat. Now comes number 7, nervous system. Nervous system comprises the brain, the spinal cord and the nerves. The brain controls the actions and reactions of the body. It controls our thoughts, memory and speech, movement of arms and legs, and the function of many organs in our body. The spinal cord is a tube-like structure that extends from lower part of the brain to the bottom of the spine. It carries signals between the brain and the rest of the body. Nerves carry out messages or instruction from brain to the rest of the body. This is the primary function of nerves. Now last one is left, reproductive system. Reproductive system is the system which helps in producing young ones. Both males and females have different reproductive system. A mother giving birth to a baby is the way through which new ones are born. I end up my video here. Thanks for watching it and have a good day. Stay home, stay safe. Bye bye.